potential need, or potential need for tracheostomy, if this was done for anything short of, as I said, on the right hand side, the lingopharyngectomies. And I think that you've got to be careful with the vagus, and also don't forget the friendly nerve. This is really, really important, oftentimes a little bit overlooked by some of our trainees, et cetera, et cetera. So the controversy still is around the concept of a planned neck dissection. I think that with the advent of the better PET scanning and PET CT, as you heard, PET CT, I think has diminished the need for planned neck dissection. You look and see what the response is. And I think that the most important thing is we've got to keep this in mind. And I'm harping on it because I think it's something that's been frequently overlooked, and not by people at your level, but in people in the community. So we've got into a very complicated area, and I'm looking forward to hearing from you. But basically, we have seen, and I have lived through the 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, and as you can see, we have adopted so many protocols from the chemo radiation protocol, the induction to concurrent to sequential, et cetera, et cetera. But as I always put it here, as we did this, and the more, basically more concurrent chemo radiation, the issue is the quality of life deteriorated? That's the reason I showed you that patient here. There's a lot of patients 5-10 years out, and they're not very happy. They have significant dysphagia, they have strictures, et cetera, et cetera. So this is a problem. I know of three in 24 hours around the world who have total pharyngoesophageal stenosis. That's 1 hour center. That's all very quickly, about a short period of time. So I think I've seen the future, as I say, but it may not work. And I'm